Hello. There's been a lot of good work going on lately in this movement. Very impressed with it all, particularly the Stinking Thinking blog and Blog Talk Radio. Two things that are very much needed, I think. I think the radio show is particularly interesting in that it allows some sort of not face-to-face, but almost face-to-face interaction between the people who are passionate about this in the form of phone-ins. Also, it allows people to be slightly more spontaneous. The problem with replying on comments on forums and on videos is that, although it's a bonus too, you get to think about what you can say. It isn't quite as interactive and real as say, a face-to-face meeting or a radio show. So yeah, those two things are great, and I mean they work very well and together in a way. I think the people that do them are friends. So yeah, it's good. I mean, I whenever something's posted on Stinking Thinking, there's hardly a time that there's not, you know, there's no one comments on it. There's a lot of good quality comments and thoughts going on that blog. Also, Orange has a forum now, I think, although I did try to join and I'm still waiting for my activation, so I'm just a spectator there. But yes, it's a good, anything's good, right? Anything, we can never have too much of these resources available to us. I think it's just nice to see that it's a small but steady growing community springing up, not just online but in other places too. I know that certain people have met each other through in the real world through challenging AA. So yes, there's lots to be positive about. Now, I haven't done much except the odd video, mostly what Mike's written, I've produced. But I was going through my Blame Denial site, which is now back online, but it's not going to be updated by me, but it's there for, you know, people to look at if they want to. And a number of things stood out for me that I wanted to look back at or look into again. One of them was the anonymous nature of people who push 12-step programs. So, for example, people who are on committees or boards or any sort of body that has the power to push 12-step recovery onto the masses. I want to look at how ethical it is to do that. So, on most boards, whether it's a business or a charity or a government or whatever, you would have to declare your interests, even if they're uncomfortable and embarrassing. So in this case, if you're pushing 12-step treatment, you can't then say, oh, didn't have to tell you because, you know, the second word of our fellowship's name is anonymous. That, to me, is highly questionable and highly unethical. And if it's I want to be able to explain that in a better way through the medium of video, because I think it's something that needs to be highlighted, because people often comment on our videos and say, well, the 12-step program is the most effective, most used, most widely regarded program there is. And I want to explain why that is, despite the fact it has a questionable success rate, which is the next point I'll move on to. This 5% success rate from the trainer surveys in 1989. I want to research that further too, because there's some, you know, sometimes the people who disagree with us do give us some things to think about. And one of those things is I want to get a clearer perspective on why either the 5% success rate is inaccurate because it's too high, or why it's impossible to explain or do a proper peer-reviewed scientific study on the efficacy of AA. Another video, I think. And the third thing, which I think Blog Talk Radio has made me reconsider, is the sexual abuse, particularly towards women, that happens within the rooms. As I've always said, I will never pick on an individual or accuse an individual of that unless they've been through the due process of a court trial. But that doesn't mean as a subject, it's something that I'm not, that I would, you know, I'm happy to tackle. I would happy, you know, happy to warn people about it. And I think I do it slightly in the warning sponsors video, but perhaps, you know, it's something that needs a bit more attention. And of course, it's not just exclusive to women, is it? I mean, I have heard of men being taken advantage of, so let me correct that. So, yeah, those are the things. One of the criticisms I get is that, you know, AA in the UK is not the same as it is in the US, and I think that's bollocks, because basically AA is a program, and the program is the same wherever you go. There's very little room for interpretation. AA might be bigger in America, AA might be endorsed by the court system in America, but it doesn't mean that AA is different in America. AA is what it is. I've always believed that. So, yeah, those are the things I want to look at. And now I've got a bit of time over the summer, I might be able to actually get it done. Anyway, I hope you're well. I hope this update hasn't bored you too much, and look forward to hearing from you.